Right, I'm here in my sketching app and I put in some inspirational images that I want my detergent bottle design to be based on. Here the idea is to have this pouch feel that we get from these refillment bottles or refillment pouches. But I want to bring that over into a refillable version. This is my initial sketch for this design. So I exported it as a JPEG and let's bring it over to Shapr. I'll create a new file. Let's add the image. And we want to turn it to be aligned with the set plane. And also move it up in order to align the bottom with the floor. And let's change the opacity of that image. We don't need it to be super opaque. We can just have it as a background. And the last step is to check the size. So let's create a sketch on this side view and we'll just create a line from the center point. And we'll make that 200 millimeter in length and that's our baseline. So for next step, let's exit and click the or select the image again. And what we're gonna do is move this a little bit to the right in order to align the left lower part of our sketch with the origin point. And then let's click scale and move the center point of scale to our origin point here. And if this snapping doesn't work for you, you might wanna enable it. So go to the right upper hand side and then click or select all the parts that you wanna snap to. All right, let's zoom out and increase the size of our sketch. And you can see how here we are aligned and that doesn't have to be very precise. All right, now we have the sketch in the correct scale. So now we can jump back into our sketch. Just highlight the line down here and it automatically goes into our sketch number one. And we are going to create this outline of our design. I will usually always lock our baseline, which makes the rest of the sketch much easier because it has a locked origin point. If you wanna use a 45 degree angle now here for this upper line, we can select the line and also our baseline. And down here where they meet, we can select our 45 degree angle. And a quick tip for your sketch, you can do something called overbuilding, which is simply drawing the line and then letting it intersect with other lines in order to rough in the shape. And then you can always use the trim tool in order to trim away the excess lines. And in a sketch, I always keep these rounded parts sharp. That allows me later on to put in a fillet, which also makes the sketch a little bit more tidy. All right, the last step here in our sketch is also to create our inner lines. So this one is the edge where the volume will be created. And I'll just add some constraints and dimensions in order to lock in the sketch itself. So for example, our distance for the handle is very important, so I will definitely put in a dimension here. So this was the first step, getting the sketch into Shapr and redrawing our outline. And in the next step, we're gonna create 3D data from it.